Good evening, everybody. My name is David Mauricio Solano-Varela. I'm one of the authors of the following lecture. We're going to talk about today a case report titled Operative Management of Gunshot Wound to the Anterior Cervical Spine for Prevention of Lane Stability. So all the authors can confirm that there are no financial relationships to disclose. Also that we can confirm that there is no conflict of interest and that there are not financial relationships of any type. So, surgery for patients with gunshot wounds to the cervical spine remains a controversial topic. However, the presence of neurological damage, cerebrospinal fluid leakage, or signs of instability are surgical indications. On the cervical spine, the instability is difficult to rule out in patients with gunshot wounds, mainly because often they also have another gunshot wounds or brain damage that difficult the examination of the patient. So we would like to present you a case of a patient with an extensive C2-C3 disc damage, treated by operative management to prevent lane spine stability. So we're going to talk about a little bit of the description of this case. We had a 24-year-old male presented with a gunshot wound with entrance hole at right malar region without an exit hole. At neurological exam, right upper limb paresis 4 from 5 was present. The cervical spine CT showed bullet fragments in C2-C3 intervertebral disc with upper end plate fracture and C2 posterior wall fracture. We also performed a CT angiography, which ruled out vascular injury, and also we had doubts about performing an MRI, mainly because of the risk of fragments migration or heating. So we didn't want to contribute to a declining on the neurological function or the instability of the spine. So we finally declined for the MRI and this exam was performed. It unveiled fragments and extruded disc intraspinal canal directed to the right side, going equal to the paresis of the right upper limb. The compression and posterior wall damage was also present. These findings and neurological compromise of the patient gave the patient an instability condition. So he underwent decompression, resection of splinters, and fusion using a PICC cage with superior and inferior screws in midline to stabilize the spine body and while preventing expulsion of the implant. So we had a proper result with an postoperative X-ray and TAC and CT image showed a construct stability. We followed up the patient for 18 months and we could see an improvement in motor function and early return to work. So, having in mind that, we can conclude the following steps. The assessment of spinal lane stability in gunshot wounds patients remains difficult to rule out, so more information is still needed to establish management protocols. Also, the optimal management of these patients has not been determined. However, spinal stability and neurological deficit are clear indications of operative treatment to improve rehabilitation and minimize socioeconomic impact. Finally, the placement of a PICC cage can prevent late spine stability in this type of patients and can contribute to the stability of the cervical spine and remains as a good alternative for the treatment of these kind of patients. Thank you very much to all the audience looking into this lecture and the IWBNC Organization Committee for the opportunity.